As she lay dying upon her deathbed, she looked up at Marshal Torrance and she said, Lucas McCain will be laid to rest within a month after my death. For the crimes that he committed against my man, for robbing me of him and turning him in. Marshal Torrance replied, your husband robbed our bank. We were glad to take custody of your husband and his gang. Lucas tracked him down and brought him in. This town will be forever grateful to him. She said it was never proven who committed the crime, and my husband died in prison before he could do his time. But now I can close my eyes and die in peace, knowing Lucas McCain will not be long after me. The marshal didn't know what to make of it all until her will was read to the town after they were called. She said all of my estate, which consists of 20 grand, goes to the one who kills Lucas, be it woman or man. His death must take place within 2 weeks of mine, and my estate will be dispersed to the one who has the spine to challenge him and shoot him down so everyone can watch him die in North Fork Town. Needless to say, the quick guns came to the territory, challenging Lucas to a duel out in the streets. But the rifleman outdueled them when they forced his hand, and by the end of the 2 weeks, he was the only one left to stand. Now $20,000 is a lot of cash, but the townsfolk respected him and his son and would not turn their backs on them. Although the tension in the town was high, the 2 weeks expired without seeing Lucas have to die. Then the marshal discovered that the money left in her estate matched the numbers to money robbed from a bank in Santa Fe. So if Lucas had been killed within the 2 weeks, the killer would have been hung and no bounty received. So ends another Rifleman episode, as a father and his son into the sunset roll.